How are you doing, my foodie friend? Today I will share the recipe to make momos at home with you all. You might be missing having momos staying home, so let's get started. Here I am taking 1 cup flour, which is all-purpose flour, and to that flour I am adding 1/2 teaspoon baking powder. Now here I am adding water. Add water little at a time, because if you add the water all at once, your dough may get wet and it will be very difficult to make momos with the wet dough. If you guys have noticed, I haven't added salt into it, because you do not need to put salt in the dough to make momos. Mix it by using your hand. You need very soft dough to make momos. If your dough is stiff, your momos will be very tough. So make sure your dough is soft. Knead it well. See, you can see how soft it is. Knead the dough for 5 minutes at least. And after kneading the dough, keep it covered with damp cloth for 30 minutes. So in the meantime, we can make the filling for our momos. We are making veg momos, so filling will be with vegetables. Now our dough is ready, as you can see. Make a ball out of your dough and keep it, as I said, covered with damp cloth for at least 30 minutes. And in the meantime, we will be making the filling for our momos. So let's get started with the filling. So for the filling, heat oil in your wok. Here I am using vegetable oil. Why vegetable oil? Because it is more preferable for momos. Now here I am adding chopped onion. Give it a stir. Remember, we do not want our onions to be brown, so keep watch on that. Now, finely chopped garlic. Again, give it a stir. As I said, we do not want your onions to be brown for the filling of momos, so keep your eye on that. I do not cook Chinese food often, but so many people were asking me to make a video on that, and my sisters love momos, so I had to make for them also. And if you know, you cannot keep your sister from having street food like pani puri, momos, chaat and all. Here I am adding chopped green chilies. You can add as per your taste. I don't like much spicy foods, that's why I am adding less. You can add more if you want. In the filling of my momos today, I am skipping the carrots, because I don't have carrots at home and I could not get carrots from market. So I am skipping that thing. If you have carrots, you should add carrots also in your filling. So here I am using only chopped cabbage. Add chopped cabbage and carrots also if you have, and give it a stir. Remember, do not brown your vegetables. I do not cook Chinese food often, but still you will find soya sauce, vinegar and Chinese condiments at my home. Why? Because my younger brother is so fond of Chinese food and he often cooks Chinese food for himself. And you know, he cooks food for himself at 3 or 4 a.m. I don't know why, but he does. And I have to admit, he's a very good cook. Okay, now let's back to our filling. Now I'm adding vinegar into it. After vinegar, give it a stir. I'm adding less vinegar and more soy sauce. Why? Because I wanted my filling to look brown, not by caramelization of my vegetables, but with soy sauce. Now give it a very good stir. Keep stirring it. You can add salt at this stage, but remember, we have added soy sauce and it is salty, so put little salt, then taste it, then you can add more if you need, but always check seasoning before adding more. Keep stirring. Now here I'm adding very little salt. As I said, I have added more soy sauce. Now give it a last stir before keeping it aside. After keeping your filling aside, we have to start working with our dough to make momos. To make momos, roll your dough into length like I'm doing. If you know how we make puris, it is the same method, but it will be very small balls out of dough. While rolling the dough like this, I had been feeling like I'm rolling the snake. But anyways, we are not making snake, we are making momos. So let's focus on that. Keep rolling. Now cut your length rolled dough into equal portions. I found it easier way to make momos. Otherwise, people take some dough, the entire batch, and they roll it individually. I found it easier, so I am following this. You can do whatever you want. You also can use cutter, cookie cutters, to cut your dough. Roll your dough into small peda or small ball. And I found this is toughest part because I am not very good with rolling round rotis, so I had to make this round. It was quite a big task for me, but I had to manage somehow, and I did that. See, it is not so round, but quite fine to make momos. So to make momos, as you know, we have to put some filling into it. So it has to be very not so very thin, not so very thick. Put filling at the center of your roll dough and start collecting from this side. See how I'm folding it, taking an overfold on the other like I'm doing. Again, I'm not professional at making momos, but yes, I made quite good momos, I had to admit. See how I'm struggling, but at least when you're learning something, you have to struggle, but result will be very good. See, it's beautiful, doesn't it? Okay, so we have plate full of momos ready. Now time to put them into steamer. As you can see, I did not have momo steamer, so I had used that idli steamer. So if you have momo steamer, you can use that, and if you don't have, idli steamer will do. And you do not need to apply oil on these plates. Your momos will come out after they get cooked. So cover it up and cook for at least 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, check your momos. They will be looking very, very shiny like this. You can see how beautiful it is. You can have your momos with Szechuan sauce and mayonnaise. If you guys like my video, do like, comment, share, and subscribe. Thank you.